For a complexity class like NP, what we are often interested in is to find the problems in that class that belong to the most difficult problems in that class. And these problems also kind of represent the class, so they're kind of good examples of what the class is really about. To this end, we define a new complexity class which is contained in the class NP and is supposed to contain the most difficult problems in NP. This class is called NP complete. The formal definition is as follows. A problem Y that is contained in NP is also contained in NP complete if for every problem X in NP, X polynomial time K produces to Y. This is one of the most important definitions that you will hear from me, and therefore I will repeat it again. So a problem is NP complete if it is in NP, and if every problem in NP polynomial time K produces to it. Suppose Y is an NP complete problem, then Y is solvable in polynomial time if and only if P is equal to NP. So if the two classes P and NP are actually the same. For the proof, we need to consider two directions. So first of all, if P is equal to NP, well, then it should follow that Y is solvable in polynomial time. But if Y is NP complete, it is in particular contained in NP. And if P is equal to NP, it means Y is also in P. And then by definition, it can be solved in polynomial time. So this direction is true. For the other direction, suppose Y can be solved in polynomial time. Now we have to show that P equals NP in that case, so that we can solve every problem in NP in polynomial time. So let X be any problem in NP. We know, because Y is NP complete, that X polynomial time K produces to Y. But then if we can solve Y in polynomial time, we can also solve X in polynomial time. Because to solve X, we would simply take the input, feed it through our transformation that's given by the carb reduction, and then solve the resulting instance for the problem Y. The first step, the transformation, runs in polynomial time because we have a polynomial time carb reduction here. And the second step also takes polynomial time because we said we can solve Y in polynomial time. So this means that every problem in NP can be solved in polynomial time, and that means NP must be a subset of P. But we already know that P is also contained in NP, and therefore P must be equal to NP. Don't write the following down whenever you're asked to give a formal answer to anything, but in a very vague and intuitive way, this is how you should think about this question of P equals NP. Like, what does it mean for P to equal NP, or what does it mean for P not to be equal to NP? The definition of NP was that we have a way for yes instances to convince somebody easily that it is indeed a yes instance. Remember, we had something like a certificate or a proof that could demonstrate to somebody that a word is in the language. And that person could easily check this proof to verify that, yes, I believe the word is in the language. So if P is equal to NP, it means that there's really no difference whether I give you some extra information that you can then check or not. You could easily check yourself always whether a word is in the language or not, right? You would not need this additional proof or certificate. If P is equal to NP, then there's sort of no additional benefit for having this certificate. At least not in the sense of whether something is solvable in polynomial time or not. It might speed up things a little, but it's not going to speed up things significantly in the sense that maybe the running time would be reduced from something exponential to something polynomial. The definition of this class NP-complete seems to make sense. I mean, we want to identify the hardest problem in the class NP. So we are looking for the problems that have the property that all the other problems in NP reduce to them in polynomial time. But the definition is only useful if there actually are NP-complete problems. We don't know this yet. I mean, right now it could be that this is a nice definition, but there are no problems in NP that satisfy this condition. So the question is, do there exist NP-complete problems? Do we even have one? Fortunately, the answer to this question is yes. NP-complete problems really do exist, and you can create and build a somewhat artificial NP-complete problem rather easily, but I will not do this here. Instead, what we will ask is a slightly more complicated question, which is, do there exist natural NP-complete problems? And the word natural is not really a formal description, it just has an intuitive meaning. It's asking whether there exists a problem that maybe we would actually want to solve, something that doesn't seem overly artificially constructed, that is NP-complete. Luckily, even the answer to that question is yes. Such problems do exist.